Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing good. Today we'll be talking about descriptive and inferential statistics and the difference between them. This is Mohammed Abdullah Sarkar, and please turn on your captions if you have trouble following along. Let's get started. In statistics, the population is a large data set about which we want to find out. I'll help you understand with examples later on. The sample is simply a part of the population which we use to derive approximations and generalizations about the population. We use the sample because it is a very tedious and difficult task to take the data of every single member of the population. Think about India. It is not easy to collect the data of 1.21 billion people. On top of that, the sample must not be biased. As if you wish to find out the average salary of Indians, you better make sure that your sample size does not consist only of doctors. To ensure that the sample is not biased, we use sampling techniques which we will discuss in later videos. On top of that, the properties of the population are known as parameters, whereas the properties of a sample are known as statistics. We have already talked about how statistics can refer to numerical data, the methods of calculating that data, and the summarization of data. To say that the properties of a sample is called statistics means that we are talking about the summarization of data. In an ideal case, the statistics of the population would match the parameters of the population, as in the sample would perfectly reflect the properties of the population. This rarely happens because a lot of errors creep in here and there. One example would be the calculation of mean. Ideally, the mean of the sample, which is a statistic, should be the same as the mean of the population, which is a parameter. This rarely happens, which is why researchers use multiple samples from a single population and find out their respective means. Then they find the mean of these individual means to reach a more conclusive result about the population's parameter. To understand, let's say Domino's and Pizza Hut come to your class for a survey. You have no clue how jealous I am of you at this moment. Now, Domino's just wants to find out the favorite pizza of your class. They wish to focus completely on you and have nothing to do with the rest of the school. They're focused on describing all the opinions of the kids and the summary of the same. Their results aim to define your class's response. On the other hand, Pizza Hut wishes to focus on the favorite pizza of the entire school, but they have come only to you and probably a few other classes in order to make their conclusion more accurate, so that you are now being used as a sample. They wish to draw conclusions about the entire school from your class and any other class if they wish to survey them. They are using a hypothesis. For example, this particular school loves cheese pizza, which is something that can be proved or disproved. You see, these Pizza Hut guys with their notepads out, and they're making complex calculations and deductions. They wish to understand the response of the entire school from you. Domino's starts with a D, and so does descriptive. Hence, Domino's represents descriptive statistics. Pizza Hut represents inferential statistics. Let me highlight a few more differences. Descriptive statistics is describing the basic features of the dataset, such as the mean, median, and mode of the sample, which are also known as the central tendency. Your data is being depicted as bar graphs or pie charts, and the properties of that graph, such as skewness, is being studied. On the other hand, inferential statistics is trying to make predictions about the entire school, which includes your class as well. Our friend Pizza Hut wants to know how many of you are going to buy cheese pizza. Remember them making complex calculations on their notepad? That's what we call probability, and it is much harder than your 10th grade probability calculations. One key difference here is that descriptive statistics work best when we have a small data set, whereas we use inferential statistics when we have a large data set. Let's go back to your class. Let's say your class makes up about 10% of the entire school. The rest of the school makes up 90%, and you too make up 100%, which is basically the population in question. As long as we're talking solely about your class, the chosen 10%, man, this has a Lord of the Rings feel to it, we'll be employing descriptive statistics. The moment we try to draw inferences about the entire population, we switch to inferential statistics. For example, let's say Pizza Hut finds out that 20% of your class likes cheese pizza. So we can say that if we extrapolate this conclusion, we find that 20% of the entire population, not just your class or the rest of the school, but the two of you combined. So 20% of the entire population likes cheese pizza. Of course, it won't be completely accurate. So we say that there is a margin of error of plus minus 2%, which basically means that the percentage of people who like cheese pizza in your school lies somewhere between 18 to 22%. We'll talk about margin of error in another video. On top of that, we can say that the confidence interval of our conclusion is 95%, which basically means that we are 95% sure that the answer lies somewhere between 18 and 22%. We can change this by, for example, increasing our sample size. Remember how I mentioned that these pizza guys may go to other classes? Well, if they do, then they would not be drawing their conclusions from 10% of the population, but rather say 30%. Conclusions drawn from 30% of the population are bound to be more accurate than conclusions drawn from only 10% of the population. Thus, as the sample size increases, our confidence interval goes up. We'll talk about confidence intervals more in the next few videos. Thank you for watching this video, and I'm happy if you stayed till the end. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And if you want more videos, let me know what should I be working on next. Stay tuned for episode 3. Take care.